Good morning to all. This is Dr. Y. Sujata, Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, BBS Engineering College, Autonomous, Odalriv. In this lecture, we discuss work holding devices and tool holding devices. Previous lecture, already we discussed types of lathe and what are the different operations are done on the lathe machine. Now, we discuss that operations we need some helping instruments. To discuss here now work holding devices and tool holding devices. This work holding devices and tool holding devices is called as lathe accessories. This lathe accessories are used for holding and supporting the work and tool on the lathe or is called as lathe accessories. This lathe accessories are divided two types. First one is the work holding devices. Lathe accessories can be classified as two types, work holding devices and tool holding devices. First we know the what is the meaning of work holding devices. Work holding devices means to hold the workpiece and to grip the workpiece to perform the operation smoothly without vibrations, called as work holding devices. Work holding devices are here available, some types are there. They are lathe centers, face plates, mandrels, steady and follower rest, lathe ducts and drive plates. These are the work holding devices. These tools are used to hold the workpiece. That's why it is called as work holding devices. Next we know what is the meaning of tool holding devices are cutting tool holding devices. Here tool holding devices means it hold the tool. Which tools are we use to holding the tool purpose, the tools are called as tool holding devices. The devices, what are they here? Straight and offset tool holder, threading and tool holders, boring bars, turret and tool post. Next, first we discuss the here work holding devices. What is the purpose of work holding devices? You know that already. In various work holding attachments such as trija checks, collects, centers, mandrels and angle plate, rest, jigs and fixers are the trija checks, collects, work holding devices. First we discuss the work holding devices. The various work holding devices are there: trija checks, forja checks, centers, collects, angle plate, face plate. These are the already we discussed. These types are available in work holding devices. Here work holding devices, already we discussed the previous slide. What are the holding devices are available? Now what is the one by one we discuss here. What is here? First checks here, trija check and forja check, and collects are consists of tubular brushing with longitudinal slits. Collects are used to grasp and hold a bar stock. A collect of exact diameter is required to match the any bar stock diameter. So first we need to discuss here of the work holding devices. Used extensively for holding work for machining operations, work large or unusual shapes. Most commonly used in lathe checks are trija centering checks, forja check, combination check, collect check, magnetic check, air or hydraulic operated check, drill check. And these checks are work of short length, large diameter and irregular and regular shapes can be held in the checks. The check is mounted on the spindle of the lathe. The work is clamped between the jaws and tightened. These are the checks. Here slide you observe the figure is also there. Trija self-centering check. What is a trija self-centering check? Here only three jaws are there. It consists of as a cylindrical body having three jaws fixed radially as its front. When the check key is tightened, all the jaws will make equal distance. simultaneously and the work is centered automatically. The workpiece of round, hexagonal and other irregular shapes can be held in it very easily and in almost no time. This its greatest advantage, however, it is not suitable for out of round them. This is the trija self-centering check. Why it is called as self-centering means we tighten the only one key, check key. That's why it is called as self-centering check. Grasp work quickly and accurate with few thousands and inches. Three jaws move simultaneously and usually it has three jaws adjusting the pinion and it is rotated. The advantage of the universal scroll check is its ease of operation in centering work for centering turning. Next, forja check. This forja check is used to hold round, square, hexagonal and irregular shaped workpiece. It has four jaws. Each jaw can be moved independently and which the check key is tightened, that particular jaw only will move. Thus, irregular jaws can be held by moving each jaw to the required amount. The jaw is reversible and it will hold the workpiece of large size also. Concentric circles are inscribed on the face of the forja check for quick centering, however setting in time and for the forja check is more than the trija self-centering check. Here trija check is not yet accurate at the independent, but here forja check is the, it is independently moved by each individual. That's why it takes the more time compared to trija check. Here in this slide you observe that what are the jaws are there, trija check, forja check. Trija check we are done on the operations. What are the operations we are used in on trija check? Cylindrical, stock centered and for facing and centered, drilling extra. Next, forja check. Four jaws, you observe this figure, four jaws are there. This is independent check, generally has four jaws which are adjusted by individually and check face by means of adjusting screws. Next is the collect check. This collect check, it is most widely used for holding bars of small sizes below 63 mm. It is normally used where the mass production work is required as in capstan lathe and automatic lathe. The front portion, the collect is splitted, which is provides the springy action and hence the grip. Thus it is called as the collect check, is used to hold the small work pieces. Next is the magnetic check. In this figure you observe the magnetic check. Here magnetic check, these are used to hold the steel work pieces that are too thin to built in ordinary check. The face of the check is magnetized by permanent magnets contained within the check. That's why it is called as magnetic check. Next, lathe centers. This is the second work holding devices. This lathe centers are hardened steel devices used for holding and rotating to the work to be turned. The center that is fitted in the headstock spindle is called is live center, that is used in tile stock is dead center. Already we discussed in lathe machines have two centers are there. One is live center, second one is the dead center. Which center is there headstock, that is called as live center. Which center is there tile stock, that is called as dead center. This lathe centers work to be turned between the must have the center hole drilled in each provide for the supported. What are the centers are there here in this figure you observe, these are the called as centers work holding between centers, line center and dead center. Okay, what are the centers are there? Ordinary centers, ball centers, tipu centers, half center, revolving center, pipe center, inset type center. Why centers it is called as work holding devices? Means it holds the workpiece between two centers. What? That's why it is called as work holding devices. Next, ordinary center. What is ordinary center here? Ordinary center is most common, generally used for general work purposes. That is, it is called as ordinary center. Next, ball center. This has the ball shape at the end to minimize the wear and strain. This is particular suitable for taper turning. Next, tip center. Hard alloy tip is brushed into the steel shank. The hard tip is wear resistant. Next one is half center. The half center is similar to ordinary center, except that a little less than half of the facility spacing of the bar ends without removal of the center. These centers are supporting the cutting. Most common have solid Morse taper shank. This 60 centers still which is capable is the tips. Care to adjust the and lubricate. Care to adjust and lubricate the occasionally. Next, mandrels. Type of mandrels here. Different types of mandrels are available. First, why we use the mandrel? It is used for holding hollow workpiece between centers. Uses of mandrel is, however, confined to relatively and small jobs, since in the case of very big jobs, there is a always likelihood of their rotating over the mandrels. So, in this purpose, we are used the mandrel. Here, in this figure, you observe that various types of mandrels are to hold the workpiece for turning. What are the various types? Plain mandrel, step mandrel, screwed mandrel, expansion mandrel, collar mandrel, cone mandrel, and gang mandrel. These are the types. What is the first? Plain mandrel, plain mandrel, and step mandrel. Here, plain mandrel body is slightly tapered in order to grip the workpiece. This type of mandrel is suitable for only size of bore. For different sizes, different mandrels are used. Solid mandrel. The solid mandrel facilitates the use of same for various jobs having different size holes. Next, gang mandrel. Gang mandrel, this has a fixed collar at the one end and a movable collar at the threaded end, which may be adjusted to its position by a nut. This mandrel is used to hold a set to hollow workpiece between two collars by tightening the nut. Next one, cone mandrel. It consists of a solid cone attached to the one end of the body and a sliding cone which can be adjusted by turning a nut at the threaded nut end. Workpiece having different hole diameters can be held by placing the workpiece on two cones and tightening the nut. These are the mandrels, work holding devices. One of the parts are mandrel. Next, rest. The rest is a mechanical device which supports a long slender workpiece when it is turned between the centers or by a check at some intermediate point to prevent the bending the workpiece cut to its own weight and vibration set up due to cutting forces. In this purpose we are used the rest. Here types of rest are there. Two types of rest are available, and steady rest and follower rest. What is the steady rest? First, in this figure you observe here, first one is the steady rest and next one is the follower rest. And first, steady rest. Here, the steady rest consists of a cast iron frame made of two parts, hinged together on one side. The upper part can be swing back for inserting or removing the jaw. Without distributing the position of the study rest, it can be clamped any desired position on the lay bed guideways. Next we discuss follower rest. Here parts you observe that hinge, jaws and workpiece. How we clamp in between the study rest. Follower rest performs the same function as a study rest because but it attached to the saddle and moves along the tool. But it moves the study rest means it locate only one place, it can't move. It fixes the one place. But follower rest, it moves the attached to the saddle, it moves along the tool. It prevents the jaw from spring away when cut is given. These are the study rest and follower. Next we discuss tool holding devices. To hold the tool, which tools are we used? The tools is called as tool holding devices. Here you observe the in this figure tool post. Tool post is fitted on the top of the slide and it carries the cutting tool or cutting tool holder. It can adjust the height on some types. In this figure you observe here what are the parts are there? Locking screw, tool holder, rocker and rocker square arm. Next can carry the four different tools here and tool holder also here there. Next, tool holders are used for holding the cutting tool bits. What are the types of tool holders? Right hand tool holder, left hand tool holder and straight tool holder. Three types of tool holders are available. Right hand tool holder, it is used for holding the cutting tool bits available in right hand, left hand and straight. So right hand, left hand and straight. So three types of tool holders: right hand tool holder, left hand tool holder, straight tool holder. Next, cutting tools can be high speed steel in tool holder, can also be ceramic tungsten bits, tungsten carbide bits held in directly tool post. Tool bit and tip tool. We are used here different shapes on high speed tool bits to cut the different shapes on the workpiece. Different types of lathe dogs. Standard bent tile lathe dog, mostly commonly used for round workpieces. Available with square head set screws of headless set screws. Straight tail lathe dog. In this slide you observe that here two dogs, lathe dogs are there. Driven by stirred drive plate, used in precision turning. Next, some more types are there. Safety clamp the lathe dog, used to hold variety of work pieces and wide range of work adjustment. Clamp lathe dog, wide range of others, used on snaps also there. All shapes are here used. Next, lathe attachments. This lathe attachments are number of attachment used on the lathe to increase efficiency and production. Are commonly used lathe attachments are, what are the purpose we are used in the lathe attachment, extra attachments, some operations, what are they? Taper turning and threading. Taper turning here is the taper turning, methods of taper turning, form tools, filling compound rest, taper turning attachment, simultaneous, longitudinal and cross feed. These are the taper turning methods. Later we discuss. First here, taper turning attachment is there. Taper turning attachment in this slide, cross feed, bolt, and what are the here attachments are there? Stops, grinding attachment, milling attachment, taper turning attachment, copying attachment, relieving attachment and threading attachment. That means some operations we need and extra arrangement and extra attachments. That attachments, what are the operations? Milling, grinding, threading, taper, copying and relieving. These are the operations we done on the attachments. Stops. What is the meaning of stops? These are used on the carriage and cross slide to position them accurately. These are used for repeated accuracy. These are used for repeated works. These stops save set time. That means these stops are saved setup time and given more accurate works. That's purpose we are used the stops. Next, tapper attachment, and next one is the grinding attachment also is there. First we discuss the tapper attachment. This is used for producing tappers on cylindricals. Similarly, various attachments like coping attachment and relieving attachment can be used on lathe. Here a red bracket and keeps the angle plate from moving of the left or the right. The carriage brackets angle plate in a dovetail and keeps the angle here. Carrying bracket moves an angle plate in a dovetail and keeps the angle plate from moving in or out of the bed bracket. Tapper to be cut is set by placing the guide bar which clamps to the angle plate at an angle to the base of the lathe bed. Next, third point, sliding black which rides on a dovetail on upper surface of the guide bar is secured during the machining operation to the cross slide bar of the carriage which cross feed screws of the carriage being disconnected. Carriage is traversed during the feeding operation. The cross slide bar follows the guide bar moving the predetermined angle of the base of the bed. These are the reasons for tapper attachment. Here it is not necessary to remove the tapper attachment when the straight turning is desired. Next one is the thread cutting attachment. On the lathe, internal and external threads are cut either with the help of thread tool or with the help of tap and die respectively. In thread cutting, we take the in thread cutting operation, we are done on the lathe machine, internal, we produce the lathe machine, internal and external threads. So there should be a certain relation between job revolutions and the revolutions of the lead screw to the control linear movement of the tool parallel to the job. When the half nut is engaged with the lead screw, the tool should be ground to the proper shape or profile. Of the thread to be cut. In modern lathe, quick change in gearbox is provided in which different ratios of the spindle and lead screw. Here next, grinding attachment. A special grinding attachment is mounted on the cross slide of the lathe. Both the grinding wheel and the jaw are rotated during the grinding. For grinding external surfaces, the workpiece is revolved between centers. For internal grinding, the workpiece is revolved in a chuck or plate. Longitudinal feed is given by the carriage. Depth of cut is given by cross slide. Next, milling attachment. In milling, operations are done on the lathe by using milling attachment. That means on lathe operation, different operations are done on the lathe machine. Some operations we need to provide the extra attachment. That attachments some are there in milling operations, milling attachment, threading operations, thread cutting operations, in tapper turning attachment. Milling operation, the milling cutter is held in a chuck and rotated. The work is supported on the cross slide by a special attachment. The work is fed against by rotating the milling cutter. The depth of the cut is given by vertical adjustment of the work is given by the attachment. This method is used for cutting keyways or grooves. The work is supported between centers and does not rotate. The milling attachment is mounted on the carriage. The cutter is driven by a separate motor. The feeding is given by the carriage. The cutter can be moved by vertically in the attachment. So these are the attachments of the lathe machine. some extra operations we are done on the lathe machine, some critical operations, but we arrange the extra attachments. Here we discuss in this slide, we discuss the one more time asceresis of lathe. So here you observe clearly, that's why one more time I repeated, you can understand easily. What are the asceresis of lathe? You observe here silently. 3 jaw check, 4 jaw check, collect check, checks. Centers, live center, dead center, tip center. Mandrels, plain, stepped mandrels. And turning for the self-centering check. Already we discussed what is the purpose of center check. Now we observe the in this figure clearly what are the checks are there in operations. This is the 4 jaw check. 4 jaw independent check. This is also 4 jaw check. This is also one more 4 jaw check. Next combination checks. Jaws can be moved in and out simultaneously or independently. Combination check means it combines the 3 jaw and 4 jaw check. Magnetic check also we discussed now. It is the figure of the magnetic check. I show you one more time. You understand easily in the figures. That's why I show you in 3D figures. Collect check. This is the collect check. And next, collect checks, different types of collect checks. And next, drill check. Drilling and reaming and tapping operations we are used on this type of checks. These are the only work holding devices. Lathe centers, already we discussed the left hand and right hand and straight lathe centers are there. These are the, in this figure you observe, lathe centers, steady rest, made of cast iron, it is the steady. Example you observe here, how we fix, that is a steady rest. Next it is the follower rest. Now we discuss the lathe SRSS here one more time. You identify the in the figure easily. That's why one more time I show you in PPT. These are the checks and centers and mandrels already we discussed now. And next checks are 3 types, 3 jaw check, 4 jaw check. That is in figure 3 jaw check. That is the key. This is also 3 jaw check. Next one is the 4 jaw check. Independent check. This is the 4 jaw. This figure also 4 jaw check. You observe here clearly workpiece how it holds the 4 jaw check. Combination check means it combines the 3 jaw check and 4 jaw check. Magnetic check, it is a magnetic check. Collect check. And next, different types of collect checks are visible on the figure. These are the different types of collect checks. In knurling operation, they are used in the collect check. Next, drill check. These drill checks are used for drilling, reaming and tapping operations. lathe centers. The centers are three centers are available lathe centers, left hand center, right hand center and side centers. In this figure easily you understand how to hold, give the support to workpiece, the centers and steady rest. Steady rest means it locate only one place, can't move, it gives the support to workpiece. Large workpieces, here you observe how it fix the workpiece. So steady rest. Next one is the follower rest. This follower rest means it adjusts the jaw support workpiece and it moves along the workpiece also. This is a follower rest. Then you understand the easily what is the difference between steady rest and follower rest. These are the mandrels, held and hold drill workpiece, plain mandrel, and special types of mandrels are there, step, cone, expansion, gang mandrels. Here they are used with the mandrel. Next, lathe face plate. Lathe dogs, different types of dogs are there. Dogs are for work holding devices. And driving plate, driving plate. You observe the figures clearly in holding devices already we discuss here, but in animation you can understand easily. That's why I show you in 3D figures. Here where it is used a tool holding devices. In tool holding devices we use the only tool post. These tools are held in you observe that this is the tool holding devices. This is called as tool post. Where here we are used the this parts are called tool holding devices. So there are four types of tool post are there already. First lecture we discussed single screw tool post, open, four bolt tool post, four way tool post, and next thing this is the single screw tool post means only one tool is there. Here this is the one tool, and next inside in three way this is the tool. It holds the, that's why it's called, it holds the only one tool, that's why it is called single tool tool post. This tool is clamped open side tool post. The open side means only one side is it covers and next another side is it opens. This tool is held by set of screws. The height of the cutting point can be adjusted by using the parallel packing and the strips. Here we are used the screws. This is also open tool post. Oh, here two bolts can be used held in position by two scraps and four bolts. That's why the tool height is adjusted by placing the parallel strips under the tool. It is called as two tool holder, four way tool post. Four way tool post means four sides we are fit on the four tools. That's why it is called as 4 by 2 post 2. Here you observe 4 sides are tools are there. How it looks? Next we discuss the taper turning methods. Taper turning is large variety of components used in the engineering practice is found to have conical shapes or if that having gradual reduction in its width or thickness along their length, such components is known as taper turning. Taper turning is one of the operation by which the tapered surface is produced on the workpiece. The taper is defined as uniform change of diameter workpiece is measured along its length. So this type of taper turning methods are number of taper turning performed here following. First one is the by using a form tool. Taper turning performed in the following method by using a form tool. First method, second method is by tile stuck set over. Third one is the by swilling the compound rest. Fourth by taper turning attachment. Fifth by a combinations of longitudinal and cross fits. This five methods are done on the taper turning. Find the taper angle means tan alpha equal to d1 minus d2 divided by 2l. Here d1 is the larger diameter, d2 is a smaller diameter, l is the length of the workpiece. First we find out the in taper turning. Before taking up the actual methods in taper turning, it would be advisable to ourselves with the some important considerations we are done here. Total length of the tapered, as per the definition, the total taper job is given by total d1 and d2, small diameter, large diameter. So tan alpha is equal to d1 minus d2 divided by 2l. The taper may be defined as uniform increase or decrease in the diameter of the piece of work is measured along its length. Tan alpha is equal to tan inverse d1 minus d2 divided by 2l. So that's why we find out the alpha angle here. And next, first one is the form tool method. Any method, first we find out the alpha. First one is form tool method. This form tool method, here workpiece you observe in this slide, workpiece, taper, alpha and stride direction. This form tool method is illustrated in figure. You observe the here a bored nose tool having straight cutting edge is set on the work at a half taper angle and is fed straight into the work to generate a tapered surface. The half of angle of taper will correspond to 90 degrees, 90 minus side of cutting edge angle of the tool. In this method, the tool angle should be properly checked before use. This method is limited to turn short length of the taper only. This side is due to reason that the metal is removed by center cutting edge and by increase in the length of the taper will necessities that is use of a wide cutting edge. So this form tool method will require the excessive cutting pressure which may be disturbed the work due to vibration and spoil the work surface. Turning is very short tapers up to maximum 20 mm length. However, very heavy and rigid type of length lathes. This limit may be go up as well. This is the form tool method. Here observe only tool is have different shapes is a form tool. Next one is the compound rest method. In compound rest method you observe here in tool and different directions dog, mandrel, tile stuck and face plate, tool post and tool holder, crash slide, direction of feed, compound rest, hand crank. How it arrange the easily? This method is used to cut the short and step tapers that are in given in degrees. Here compound rest is there, that is the given in degrees. The compound rest must be set to a required angle. Here is the compound rest. So this compound rest is must to be a set an angle, and the cutting tool is advanced along the taper using compound rest feed handle. The compound rest may be filled at 45 degrees on either side of the lathe axis, enabling it to turn a step taper. The movement of the tool in this method being purely controlled by hand. This is given by low production and poor surface finish. Is called as tan alpha is equal to k by 2 or k is equal to 2 alpha. Next method, taper turning attachment is there here. Taper turning attachment setting by next is the tile stack over method. This is the tile stack over method. This principle of taper turning by this method is shift the axis of rotation of the workpiece at an angle to the lathe axis and the feeling tool parallel to that lathe axis. The angle at which the axis of rotation of the workpiece is shifted is equal to half of an angle of the taper. This is done by which the body of the tile stack is made to slide on its base towards away from the operator by set over screws, as you observed here in this figure. Here D is the large diameter in taper, small d small diameters, L is the length of the work, small l is the length of taper, alpha is equal to half of the angle. The main disadvantage of this method is live and dead centers are not equally stressed and the wear is not uniform. Moreover, the lathe carrier being set at an angle and angular velocity of the work is not constant. Same formula also here also are used. So taper turning attachment also already previous we discussed. Advantage of taper turning attachment, the alignment of live and dead centers being not distributed. Thank you for listening this lecture. In this lecture we discussed the work holding devices and tool holding devices. Okay, thanks for listening this lecture.